Today's story is called The Parable of the Pharisee and the Tax Collector. One day Jesus was talking to some people that thought that they were better than everyone else. He told them this story. He said there were two men who went to a temple to pray. One was a Pharisee. Now Pharisees were men that knew the scriptures, and they strictly followed everything that it said. And the other was a tax collector. Tax collectors were hated by their own people because they would often cheat people out of their money. The Pharisee began to pray and said, "God, thank you that I am not a bad man, like robbers, evildoers, or even this tax collector. I obey your laws and I give a tenth of my money to you." Then the tax collector prayed, and he stood far away and wouldn't look up to heaven because he was ashamed. He beat his chest and said, "God, have mercy on me, for I am a sinner." So Jesus asks us this question: who do you think went home justified? Now, before I explain this story, I want to hear what you think. Which prayer do you think that God liked more, and why? Do you think he liked the Pharisee's prayer or the tax collector's prayer? Let us know in the comments below. We also want you to know that we're really glad that you're here. If you'd think about subscribing to our channel and liking this video, that'd be so awesome. So let's get back to the story. So here's what Jesus told us. He said that the tax collector is the one that went home justified and forgiven, but not the Pharisee. He said, "All those who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted." So God is looking for humble people. But how do I become humble? To be humble, we need to understand sin. But not only that, we need to understand our own sin. Did you know that sin separates us from God? That's pretty scary, but what is sin? Well, murder is a sin. Well, that seems pretty obvious that it's wrong. But what else? Even lying is a sin. Did you know that even one lie separates us from God? The crazy thing is that every person has sinned. Well, every person except for one. That one was Jesus, the man that was telling this story. He never sinned. The Bible tells us that the punishment for sin is death. So whether we murdered someone, or if we told a lie to someone, we're supposed to die. But wait a minute, there's good news. Jesus, the man who never sinned, decided to die for us. He died and took the sins of the whole world on himself. And guess what? If we believe in him, our sins are forgiven. But there's one more thing about Jesus that you need to know. Jesus isn't only a man, but he's also God. So that means God lived a perfect life and died for you. That's crazy. But you know the coolest thing? While Jesus was on earth, even though he created everything and he deserves to be our one and only king, he came as a servant to serve those around him. That's the most humble action in all of history. We need to learn from our sin that we don't deserve Jesus' forgiveness, and that we aren't in any way better than anyone else. But we can also accept what Jesus did and receive his forgiveness, not because of our goodness, but because of his.